Libya was Libya spelt incorrectly. Very sorry about that. It's L-I-B-Y-A. Best of one on cash. Well, the Moroccans starting off on the CT side. Libyans deciding to start off on the T side. Something they know a bit more about, perhaps. AK-47s, all that business. And we do have two utility players, Josh and Meredith. And a three armor, and it's going to be a standard A execute from them. Moroccans going for the B push for information. This is a good little play. And they're going to play for the A site retake. They've only got one person on the A site. Very nice, very Na'Vi Titan style. And they're throwing the truck smoke, so Razor's not going to be able to find any shots. He'll just throw a flash down to try and slow them down. And the rest of the team are going to come in. I know we've got some action here. Josh is here for the flank, and he stops that B push in its place. However, only one frag for him. Yoshi pushing forward, and he actually catches Meredith as well. Madness, absolute madness happening here on main. And now it's a 4-3 retake here for the CTs. Molotov over on the corner. We've got one person here right behind the forklift. Frosty gets shot down. Crocodile pops up with the clock. And he's playing big, gets two frags, but it's not enough as Yoshi will clutch the round and pick it up for Morocco to make it 1-0. Really nicely done by him. Good retake there. Yoshi with three frags and just making the defuse as well. Just making it. I think one of his teammates had a defuse kit, but he probably didn't have time to go pick it up. Either way, there he goes. Picks up the defuse kit and saves on for the next round. Full buy coming in from the CTs, but unfortunate. It's really good by Josh to hold that position and to hold the flank. Could have done a lot of damage if he was able to land his shots. Either way, my home country, my nation has lost the first round. There is sadness coming from my heart right now. Doesn't matter though, because we love Morocco equally as much. Molotov down, good spray down with the P90 over at mid. Put a couple of the players. Looks a full eco here from the Libyans. Very 1.6 style. But actually, no, they got the bomb plant, so it's standard, really. You go for the full buy in the third round. No frags, though, on this eco. Josh and Frosty remaining here. Josh peeking, re-peeking. We'll get finished off there. Moroccans looking pretty solid so far. 2-0. They pick up the anti-eco pretty easy. But Libya now with a full buy this round. AK-47s around. Let's see if they can show us some business with these rifles. And the Moroccans are not going to upgrade their weaponry. They're going to stay with the P90s. Yeah, they have to be careful because the Libyans are actually better equipped this round. They don't have super amounts of utility, but it's good enough. And I think they're going to go for the mid-control here. Meredith is just going to push forward from the smoke. No fear here from Meredith. Looking for the headshot. Can't find it. And you can blame it on the ping, though. Relatively high for a couple of the players, but pretty similar to the Moroccan. And they're unable to find the entry frags over at mid. They've got control, though. And at this point, they should take it easy. Get control. Wait to make the frag before you do anything. Get one frag. Remove the equilibrium with the Moroccan stat, like with the way that the Moroccans are holding their positions. Get that man advantage on the T side. And then you will probably win when you push in towards the site. So they're deciding to go towards the B side hits. Relatively good choice. Seems like the Moroccans are pretty well stacked on both sites, however. And they should have taken advantage of the mid control that they have to push in from vents at the same time. So Salah is there to take a look at vents. Meredith pushing forward here. Needs to make sure that they don't pop from checking. And there it is. That's a big mistake there from Yoshi as he gets the entry. But Salah returns with 2-3. Nicely done there with the P90. Frosty with the return, but it's far too late. Very nice job there by Salah to pick up three frags. And he makes it a 2-3, but Frosty takes down Cactus, just pushing forward through the smoke. That the bomb should be planted here. Ali Slack with a frag on Crocodile. It's all up to Frosty in a 1-2 against two Moroccan players. One coming in from CT spawn, the other from B halls. And there you have the flash, but it doesn't really do much. Frosty forced to check two angles at the same time. Will he be lucky, though, as they're both actually going to come in from the same angle? Ali Slack pushes forward, gets the entry on Frosty. And the fuse for the Moroccans as they pick up the third round here. Close round indeed by the Libyans. Excellent play from Salah. I don't know if we're going to get a replay of that, but really, really, really well played to pick up those three kills, and Morocco will take that round. 3-0 now for the Moroccans. Libya forced onto an eco. I mean, they can go for a false buy right now, but maybe save up full buy the next round. Probably a good idea. Tech Nines for a couple of the players. They do understand that. You can see both teams understanding the meta of CSGO, knowing how to use. It's a bit different to a couple of teams. A couple of teams aren't really taking advantage of the good pistols that we have in CSGO at the moment, not taking advantage of the false spies. But you see the Libyans, they do watch their CS, they do know their CS, and they do take advantage of the meta here. Josh looking for an entry now over at the A site. He has the bomb, rest of his teammate coming forward. They have one smoke, probably going to be a truck smoke. While the team pushes forward, and there's one person over at forklift who might be taken by surprise. Great flash Good smoke as well by Cactus. Really slows down this push and makes it pretty easy for him. But he's just got a bad angle there and only one frag for him. Salah there picks up another one. There's an exchange. This is a very good pistol round. They're going to get the bomb planted. Meredith goes down to Razor. And now it's a retake here by the CTs. Oh, Nonalinho pushing forward. Nicely done there. Picking up a frag. It's 2v2 and an M4 for Crocodile. Ali Slack now coming in from main. Bombs planted. Very good eco round here for the Libyans. Very good eco round. Crocodile finds one CT coming in from main. There's another from Truck over at... And as he makes the entry... And the second on Nonalinho, Yoshi playing very, very well indeed. Another double kill for him, and he's on quite a couple of frags. 6-1 for Yoshi, who's picking up the rounds. But an incredibly good pistol round for Libya. Getting the bomb planted, picking up three frags. Very nicely done. A lot of money in the bank for them now. You can go for a full buy with the op, but I don't think any of them are going to do that. Nonalinho, perhaps? I don't know who's really the op at the moment for the Libyan side, but it seems they're going to go for full AK-47s, full utility. And now they can do anything they really want. Get that early mid control. Throw down that Molotov. Good smokes here. Good smokes by the Libyans. Smoking off mid. Nonalinho looking for the entry now. Good fast movement. Finds the person in Sampax. Meredith is there to support. Good shot on Razor. Libya now. Getting ready for an A execute. And the CTs are not very aware of what's going on. They're going to have terrorists pushing in from short as well. At the same time, the Moroccans force back. But they know it's an A execute. Molotov in the site. And the Libyans now getting ready for the push in towards the A site. But Salah picks the frag. Ali Slack with another. Crocodile gets the return. Ali Slack still alive here on the corner. Gets shot down by Meredith. Meredith with his second frag of the round. And Morocco on its own. Yoshi in a 1v2. And it seems like Libya are in a good chance to pick up their first round here. Bombs being planted. And Yoshi, who did very well for the last couple of rounds, with an AWP on the retake, Molotov in hand. I know where he's going to throw that Molotov if he remembers. Change to the AK-47, good start here. Molotov on site, just in case there's one person at the corner there holding. Nobody moves out of position. Knows there's probably one person holding at deep site over at quad. Checks Piali, jumps on top. Crocodile pops out, and Crocodile gets the frag. Libya with the first round to make it 4-1. And they're back in the game here, full by round. And the economy of the CT is relatively good. Bearing in mind, they've lost quite a lot of weapons in the last couple of rounds, but they've won 4 rounds in a row, so they'll be able to go for a full buy once more. Mag 7 on Cactus, and the rest of the team able to afford M4s. Salah only with a Deagle, even though he's picked up quite a couple of rounds there. But 4-1 now. Libya, good play that round. Used the utility very well. Got mid control, and that's a nice T-side play. And the Moroccans look very dangerous indeed. Salah starts it off with an excellent shot there on Frosty. One Deag. Nonalinho in a bit of a corner here. Has to be careful. Can be a very easy frag for the CTs if they isolate him. And there's the main smoke renewed. Shots need to start landing here from the Libyans. They're getting chances to get frags, but the shots are just not there. Tactically, they're looking good, but just... They need to improve their aim ever so slightly, and I think they just have to warm up at the moment. A lot of going over at short, and the bomb should be moving towards the B site right now. Only one person on the sites. They've got one entry, and there's a two-man stack on the A site. They have to. Good CT smoke. Smokes are really on point here by the Libyans. So far, the best side when it comes to just throwing down the smokes. Really understanding cash at the moment. Entry there by Meredith. Yoshi shoots down Josh. He's in the site. They know he's over at Hedgehog. Gets another frag really nicely done there by Yoshi. Still alive. Meredith finally takes him out. It's a 2v2 with the bomb down. Yoshi doing another excellent job. Individual play here from the Moroccans to take him through. And what a fantastic frag there by Yoshi. Meredith checking CT spawn. No more utility here for the Libyans. And with time running out, they have to go for the bomb. Cactus just waiting for the sounds. Peeks forward. Nonalinho not landing the shot. Salah takes down Meredith. Finally takes him out. But it took far too many shots. 8 health left here on Nonalinho. Bomb's going to be planted in the last 10 seconds of this round. And it's a 1v1. Salah coming in from the balcony. And I think it's a bit of a mistake for Salah to come in from the same position he got a frag from before. Either way, he gets the frag on Nonalinho and the round for the Moroccans relatively easily. Good shot by him. But it's a tough position to really plant in. In a solo situation, planting there is almost like you always lose a plant in that position. It's like it's the safest plant. And I guess he wanted just a safe plant. But winning the round... It's difficult. Really, really difficult. And there you have it. Morocco with another round. But close for the Libyans. So it ended up a 1v1 with a bomb planted. And it's allowed them to keep a lot of money. And we're seeing some fantastic fresh CS here from the African qualifiers. It's absolutely wonderful to watch. Really. I'm very pleasantly surprised by both teams. One person over at Squeaky Molotov at Quad. Actually, no, that was a Bialy Molotov. There's the Molotov from Quad. Good usage of the utility here, forcing them out of position here. Razor over at Squeaky jumps on top of the balcony. I don't know if they're going to see that coming. Salah's in a great position. He's had a lot of kills. They're not going to check. Oh, Salah makes it two. Doesn't get the third. Runs out of bullets. Ali Slack taking down Meredith. And there's a bit of a mistake. One pushing in towards the site. Not getting the right angles. Not checking the site like that. Salah just easy frags for him. Ali Slack and Yoshi with the final two frags. And they didn't have to lose those three players. Again, losing far too many as they move into the site. Good tactics from the Libyans. Good smokes, good Molotovs. Entries not there. Angles not there. And the Moroccans pick themselves another round. Great individual play again from Salah and Ali Slack as they make it 6-1. Libyans now still have money though. And we're going to have a pause this round. I think might be a tactical pause by the team just to have a chat. Look at the pings. Everyone's logged in. Everyone's connected. Everything's fine. But yes, exciting start to this batch. And for those who have recently joined us, I hope you're enjoying the North African CS, but it's the African qualifiers of the World Championships. Right now, Libya versus Morocco. We just had a game earlier. Morocco versus Algeria ended 15-15. 1 point for both teams. Morocco now hunting for their 3 points. Libya as well with their first game. They've got a game against Egypt next after this at 4 o'clock, so don't miss that. Or 4:30 because of the little delay that we have. But yeah. Fantastic, absolutely fantastic. And I hope you're enjoying the broadcast here on EFRAG TV with no issues. And that everything is as good as possible. We're running a 1080p 50fps stream. For those who are interested in the technical details, and it's quite interesting because no CSGO stream actually runs 1080p 50fps. It's usually 1080p 30 or 720p 60fps. So if you're enjoying the added sharpness, if you have the internet capabilities to actually watch it, then throw us a message. Tell us what you think about it. But here we have a restart, and it's going to be an eco from Libya. They could actually go for a buy this round, but they're deciding to play with full utility instead. They're not going to play AKs and armor. And it will be a B execute. Relatively fast. And the Terror CTs are not really in position. We've got one person coming in. Oh, nice shot there by Nonolino. Takes down Ali Slack. Yoshi over at headshot. Gets one frag on Frosty. Josh is looking for him. He can't find him. We've got Meredith holding the flank here. Oh, wow. Meredith pushing in from mid. And he got himself an easy frag. Salah comes up from behind and takes him down. But I don't know how he made himself... I don't know how he got to that position. Either way, this is a very good eco run here from the Libyans. Three players taken down. Bombs down, however. No bomb plant yet. Nonolino finding someone over at balcony. Salah, again, great positioning. Great play. Baiting each other. Not really baiting each other, but using each other for... to take the... attention of the terrorist and the second player going for the frag. Team flash there, but no problem. Salah just making sure they don't come from the flank. And we have Crocodile with the Tech 9 taking his time at the moment. Perhaps wanting the CTs to switch around positions. I'm not too sure exactly what he's really thinking of, but it seems like he's completely AFK. I hope that there is no issue. And the thing is, right now, Libya has like a hench problem where we have no electricity. So it's stupid because it's a very rich country, but there's problems with electricity. So I'm assuming we might have a situation where the player just disappears because there's no electricity. So I'm hoping that doesn't happen, but you never know. It is possible. Crocodile saves a Tech 9. I think he was AFK. I think we have an issue. So we're just going to wait for this pause and to see if they're able to fix it. Crocodile, he's connected. He's got 57 ping. I don't think he's in Libya. That's the thing. But hopefully there are no issues. Anyway, big thank you to the sponsors of the World Championships. G2A.com, esportgaming.com, Nitrado, and of course, hitbox.tv. We hope that we are providing you a very good broadcast. And without them, this tournament would not happen. It would not exist. And it's an incredible tournament, really. National teams, 79 nations from all over the world, players from all over the world playing for a 16-team LAN final, very big LAN final, one of the biggest in this year because we have 16 teams and playing for 100,000 and the most global easily. I think it's more global than ESWC. We've got players from all six continents, three teams from Asia, one from Africa, two from North America, one from South America, one from Oceania, and eight from Europe. So really, really stacked tournament. It's going to be fantastic. It'll be set in Belgrade, Serbia. And for those who are interested in coming, we'll be providing all ticket information and whatnot. Sava Center is the venue, and the players' staff will be staying in the Crown Star Belgrade. Five stars, which is right connected to the server center. So it'll be fantastic LAN. I can't wait for it, and I can't wait to see which team will make it through the African qualifiers. I think it'll be pretty close. It'll be pretty close indeed. It's a shame that South Africa has a bit of a problem with ping. I hope that will not affect the standings. However, I have a feeling it will. But there's nothing you can really do about that other than making LAN qualifiers, which we hope to do that next year. Really, that's the next step, having LAN qualifiers in every continent. That would be the best case scenario. I think that would be fantastic. And I hope, believe it or not, I am a commentator, but also involved in the organization of everything. And I wouldn't do it ESWC style. I would do it really us controlling and making every single LAN qualifier to make sure that everything is as good as possible and everything is perfect, because relying on other people is usually bad things happen, as proven by the recent ESWC, where like most of the qualifiers didn't even happen. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to both the LAN final and also the possibility of continental LAN finals in the future. Seems like we've got Crocodile popping back in. Producer telling me, do you want your face on the camera? Do you want people to see your face? I was just about to say yes, but the guy just popped back in, so you guys can't see my me beautiful face. Nice, nice. And we do have a restart coming up. With the money that they have, they can go for a full buy. Crocodile, though, it's really a shame because since he survived the last round, he gets no money. So he just saved the Tech Nine. And he's not even kept it because he's re-logging in. Oh my goodness. Horrible, horrible situation to be in the corner. I guess he's just going to have to work with the Galil. Not really best case scenario for the Libyans, but they have to work with what they have. And we have two play. Oh, very, very, very aggressive by both teams over at mid. And Morocco are going to come out the better, but Meredith pops out. He gets another entry frag at mid. He's been relatively successful with that so far. Josh picking up the bomb. Seems like they're going to go for a B execute with one player coming in from it. They've already got a player in over at Checker. This is very fast. Blitzkrieg here from the Libyans. Ali Slack coming in. CT spawn smoke not there, so Ali Slack will be able to pick up frags. Yoshi's still alive. Takes down Meredith. Ali Slack with another. Ali Slack doesn't make it two. Crocodile gets a return frag. It's two versus three. Not a lot of health here. Jumps up forward. Frosty with a frag. And there's one person coming in from Checker. Salah from behind, though. And Cactus and Salah with a frag each as they retake the site. No smokes over at CT. And that is the main reason why they didn't get a bomb plant. No smoke over at CT. Too busy trying to fight the battles with the Moroccans, having a very, very fast rotate from mid and A site and making sure they didn't get the bomb planted. So eight rounds here for the Moroccans. Libyans now on a full eco. They can go for a buy. And they're deciding to go for an eco. Want to play with full utility in the next rounds. And they've had relatively good pistol rounds. I don't know why their pistol rounds have been more successful. Maybe they've kind of focused a bit more. But their pistol rounds with no armor have been pretty good. I'm very close. They've gotten the bomb planted. They've been in clutch situations. They haven't won those rounds, but very good indeed. Meredith fired through the squeaky door, and the terrorists are getting ready to push towards A site. One person holding the flank, that's Josh, and entries for days. There's Ali Slyke. Wow, nice flank there, and that's what happens when you give away mid. The thing is, Josh should have, okay, he's holding B halls, but your team is moving in towards the A site. Stand at mid. Stand at mid so you can check mid as well and make sure that they don't get flanked from there instead of just checking B halls. Better position, just like in the pistol round, would have been for Josh to be over at near T spawn to hold that flank, and he might have been able to take out Ali Slack and get himself a free weapon. But regardless, Libya now with a full buy. Op on Nonalino. Don't know if he's going to be able to do anything with that here, but he's on 8 frags so far. 8 on Meredith as well. Only 1 on Josh. And I have a feeling that he's probably the in-game leader for the team at the moment. The Crocodile, Timsah. I think they call him Timsah in Arabic, and he's just translated it to Crocodile. Because Timsah is kind of like a nickname you get sometimes. I mean, I've heard it once or twice in my life. Now, I'm just going to throw Molotov in at the B site. And it's a default setup here by the terrorists, waiting for the CTs to go aggressive. And unlike Dust2, Moroccans are being pretty passive at the moment, holding their positions, not going forward, not going aggressive. And Libyans can't take advantage of that. So it's a good CT play here by Moroccans. Ali Slack pops out, finds Meredith. And that's an easy frag here for Ali Slack. But Josh knows that there's somebody over at Vents. Probably should adjust his angle to see if Ali Slack's going to pop down and get a frag while he's popping down. But he's still going to stick his position here. And Alice is going to be pushing forward. Josh can take advantage of this. Ali Slack pushes forward. Josh gets a frag. And there's the return. Now should be the execute here from the terrorist over at the A site. And Josh should just be pushing forward from whatever position he's in to support his teammates with a lurk, with a flank. But it's not going to work now. They need to rotate towards the B side to do something else. There's three CTs ready and waiting for them. Cactus here. Bialy picks up one frag. There's a return from Crocodile. Salah in the site. Nonalino not landing any op shots this round. Crocodile with another at Timsah, making sure he is living the dream. And this is very good now for the Libyans. With the bomb planted and a 2v1, it's a chance for them to pick up a round. With 5 rounds on the T side, they can be very happy. 6 rounds would be even more fantastic. Yoshi now. He's a very, very good clutch player. He's won a lot of 2v1s. He's made a lot of double and triple kills this game. And I think he might be even top fragging for his team at the moment, but won't be able to outsmart here. The Libyans Crocodile. Big round from him. 4k. Pretty much one-man army there from Crocodile. Just love this guy. Love his name. 11 frags, 8 deaths to him. And Libya will pick up their second round. And now this is a very important round, because if they lose, the third economy will be broken. They don't have the loser bonus to rely on. And they'll be forced onto an eco the next. And which would put Morocco 11-2 up. Very aggressive from Ali Slack. Gets punished for it. Meredith takes down Razor. And that pause seemed to be working wonders for the Libyans at the moment, because it might be the start of the third round win for the Libyans here with the two entry frags. Meredith goes down over at shot. Cactus is forced back. Flash. Salah completely flashed over near forklift. Yoshi giving away the B site. CT smoke should be coming soon. Oh dear, it's a bit too late. Nonalino gets shot down. It's not even a good CT smoke as well. And the bomb's going to be planted over the B site. Yoshi backs away towards balcony. They need to hold their positions here. They need to have after planned positions. Molotov over there. Cactus is going to have to jump on. Oh, and he finds a frag, but Frosty takes him down in return. This is really, really nice. I was just about to say he found a nice cheeky frag on Frosty, but he was ready for that. Crocodile's going to get shot down from Salah. Vents. 2v2 retake now. Yoshi just pushing forward. Frosty on the side. Op versus op here. Frosty sees someone at check it on the balcony. Yoshi looks away, and Josh will take down Salah. And there you have it. Libya with a third round. And the momentum is picking. Morocco now onto an econ. We might have a games, might have a game on our hands. What is wrong with my pronunciation, guys? I can't speak English. And we might have a game on our hands now if the Libyans can secure this anti-eco. Keep it simple. Use the long distances. Oh, look at this. 5 CT stack at mid. I mean, looks like a team huddle, but Frosty needs to land these shots. Oh, gets charged. That's a lot of information. Terrorists now go towards the A site, get the bomb planted. You know they're all at mid. Razor now going to balcony. Bit slow here by the terrorists. Meredith popping out on his own. Big mistake. Could go down. No person to return the frag as well. He's peeking him. Huge mistakes here. Crocodile in a position, and he goes down as well. Not ready for him. Doesn't even let out a bullet. The bomb's moving towards the B site. Meredith takes down Ali Slack. Elise holds the flank, but that's an AK-47 for the Moroccans. And what we have here is Meredith still at Squeaky. Shot down by Razor's AK-47, which he picked up from Crocodile. 3v1 with 2 AK-47s for the Moroccans, but they've got no armor. Libyans just have to hold their angles. Bad plant position, really. Nonalino should just try and put himself in a position. I mean, it doesn't really matter. The Moroccans are actually going to go for a save, which is okay. I mean, they'll have money for a buy, but it's good for their economy. They could, if I was them, just for cheekiness, go for it. Destroy Libyan economy. Crocodile reconnecting. Seems to be having internet problems. But Libya will get their fourth round here. We do have a game on our hands. Libya now in a good position to come out of the first half with a very respectful 5 rounds. They can make it 6 if they want. The Moroccans with that save. Able to get full utility in both Razor and Yoshi. Only 2 defuse kits. I think they need more. It's a very fast speed push coming in from the terrorists. Nonalino throwing a sight flash. 2 flashes. Whoever's in the sight is probably blind as a pauper at the moment. Nobody's making sure every single corner. And there's flashes for days. Flashes all around. Counter flashes. Flashes from the tees. Everybody's blind. Everybody's having a party. But the bomb's going to be planted. And it seems like it's a clean execute of the B site by the Libyans. Very good shout here by the Libyan side to go for the B site, which is only defended by one person. Good usage of flashes and utility. Crocodile takes down Cactus, and now they're just holding the angles here and the flanks, and the CTs have lost this round. Good. Libya, after the umpause, looking a lot more solid, looking a lot more composed and organized, landing their shots and playing a good solid T side. Simple CSGO, but effective CSGO. And they're not relying on individual prowess from any of the players, except for that round by Crocodile where he got a 4K. Just about fundamental play. Go in to the site, get the entries, get the trades. I mean, there's going to be two players, three players in the B site. If you get the trades, you will have control of the site and the bomb planted. And then you play for the after plant positions. And you should be able to pick up the round. Salah, though, with 16 frags. Yoshi on 14. Two players a bit lacking behind, but it's the final round of the first half here. Been an excellent comeback so far for the Libyans to pick up four rounds in a row. Oh, Alex actually wall banked him. He's been going aggressive over at mid. It's not worked out for them. Every single time, there's been a terrorist just ready and waiting for him. Oh, he uses the smoke very, very well. Actually pops out from the left, and nobody checks him. He might get himself a cheeky frag. Mary Death with a knife out. Oh, no. Mag 7, if only he had an M4 there, he would have probably got a kill. And Crocodile's been disconnected. So Libya now playing with four players. Not the best position to be in. And it's a shame that he's had connection problems. Or maybe PC problems. You see, Josh is lagging a bit at the moment. Not the smoothest play for the Libyans. And they're doing a good job, though. Holding their ground at the moment against the Moroccans. Nonalino holding their flank. Good play here. Making sure they don't get flanked by the CTs. Good understanding. There's going to be a boost looking for a pick at mid. They're getting information as well. I think the bomb's going to be moving towards the A site. Josh is just going to make a bit of noise over at the B site. Try and fake it. Try and get a response from the CTs. And it'll be a 3-on-1 actually over at the A site. Josh with the Molotov. Josh should just push forward right now. Try and get an entry. Just make noise as the rest of the team will be moving in towards the A site. And I think Razor's aware of that. He's going to be pushing forward. Frosty might be able to get one kill over at the Lurk. And Salah with the P90. We might get a flashback of that excellent round where we picked up three frags. Razor pops out from nowhere, takes down Frosty and Merideth. And now Josh on his own in a 1v3, takes down Yoshi. 4 seconds left on the clock, needs to save that AK-47. No chance of him winning this round. And he better not die right now, or else he'll be in a lot of trouble. Actually, no, it's the end anyway. Can't do anything about it. What am I saying? It's match point, so he needs to go for it. 9-5, 10-5 actually for the Moroccans. So they should be both teams pretty happy with the rounds that they got. Libya, with the comeback, actually picking up the last four rounds. And we see that a lot on Cash, where terrorists actually able to pick up the couple of last rounds and then having momentum transfer over on the CT side and even win the games. But very nicely done here by the Libyans. But excellent CT play by the Moroccans, keeping the game under control. And now the Libyans will be on the CT side. I wonder if their CT side play will be any better. But the Moroccans showing that they've got that better aim, able to get those double and triple kills and relying a bit more on individual play from Salah, Ali Slak, and Yoshi. On the other hand, if you look at the Libyan score, I mean, other than, actually, Crocodile keeps the score even though he disconnects. It's relatively the same. I mean, Josh is down on 5. I'm assuming that Josh is probably the in-game leader. I have a feeling from the way he's been playing, like the way he's been lurking, and the fact that he knows all the smokes and flashes, I'm assuming he's the in-game leader. But we'll see. Now, Morocco, it's the pistol round, and they're doing what every smart pistol round player does, which is go straight for the site with the execute. And this is nice here by the Libyans, taking the initiative, going for the information. They know nobody's at their site. The guys at the B site should be ready for this. Molotov's in the site. Crocodile actually not really damaged by them, and he's here at headshot. Will he be able to land any headshots on return, though? Merideth picks up a frag. Crocodile there with the USP takes down Salah. It's pretty good. Razor though gets the return frag here coming in, and Crocodile goes down to it. Complete like invasion force by the Moroccans, and this is a good, oh, great play there. One guy with a crossfire to get the return frag. If Frosty goes down, now it's a 3v2. Two players remaining in the site, and they've both got armor. No utility left on the CTs. No defuse kit as well as they push forward. Alice Lyke in a fight against Josh. Gets another wonderful play there by Alice Lyke. It's all up to Nunnalino in a 1v2. And Alice Lyke plays big, gets the triple kill. Excellent play by him. Individual play going through. And he picks up the pistol round there for the Moroccans. Libya had that in the bag. It was a 3v2 retake of the site. But Alice Lyke playing big with the triple. And in fact, I don't know how many rounds he got that round, but how many kills he got that round. It was a minimum of 3. And now Libby on a force bite. 5-7s all around. P250 on Josh. Frosty. Flashed for main. But nobody's there. One person holding the flank at Squeaky. Crocodile's going to be pushing forward. Finds Yoshi. Oh, but isn't able to connect the headshot. Yoshi's going to make a bit of money with that frag. And there's a very fast rotation coming in from the CTs. You know, it's just, you saw one person at B. It doesn't mean they're going B. There's always one person at B. They've already lost 2 players with this force buy. And pistols can be really, really good. Pistols and armor. 5-7s and armor can be really, really good. 5-7 in close quarters is actually devastating. But Nade not really connecting. Nunnalino still at the corner. Sees Yoshi. Takes him out. Bomb's actually moving towards the B site here. Nunnalino still alive. Oh, gets another frag on Razor. Nunnalino. 1 health now. Got his teammate over a balcony. Picks up a frag. Nunnalino with 3. Oh my goodness. It might be a force by round win here by Frosty. 1v2, but Salah comes up from behind. Great play there by Nunnalino to get 3 kills. For a moment there, I thought it was a 1v1. With Frosty looking right at Cactus. But Salah was still alive. And Morocco will pick up that round. Very close. Great play there by Nunnalino on the site. The 5-7. Morocco well on their way though. Might be picking themselves 3 rounds. 3 points, sorry, this game. I wonder what Merry Death means. I know why Josh is called Josh, because he likes a musician called Josh something. Josh Turner? Josh something. Salah is called Salah because his name's Salah, I guess. It's pretty standard. Razor's called Razor because he's sponsored by Razor Props. Frosty doing a good job to pick up that frag at main. But the full eco from the CTs. Difficult situation. Very difficult to pick up rounds like this. The Morocco make it 13-5. Libya now with a huge, huge mountain to climb at the moment. Have to get 8 rounds in a row to catch up. And another 3 to get the win. 11 total without losing more than 1 round, since they can get the draw. Good start. Nunnalino taking down Salah, who's a bit too greedy for the frag, looking for the pick. Yoshi's going to pick up his AWP as well. Meredith, a bit unlucky with a spray down there through the smoke. And with a one-man advantage here, the CTs shouldn't do anything crazy. Stay back, hold your angles. No need to go aggressive, no need to make any risks at the moment. It seems like Josh is going to be flashed through by Meredith. Finds nobody. Terrorists still with a very neutral position at mid. Frosty's going to see a lot of action here. Gets information. Holds the angle. Smoke over at mid. Teammates holding position. Can go for the lurk if they want to. Frosty's seen at least 2 terrorists. Might be even 3. And a double nade comes across, but he moves out just at the right moment. Yoshi's down to 44 health. Josh still here at main. And the terrorists are going towards the B site. It's a good call here by the CTs to go for the rotation, though. We've got 1 person at balcony, 2 in the B site itself. And Josh just holding main on his own. And Frosty right now, holding mid. Not good position, really, for him to be in. Because he can actually help A now. Like, from this position, he can help A. But 3 in the site, Crocodile. At deep site. There's the Molotov as well in return, so it's forcing him out. Flashes, good utility Usyk by the Moroccans to push in. Nonolino still alive. He did an excellent job with the 5-7 armor. Can he do the same with the M4? Run out bullet with the M4. Pops out the USP. Picks up a frag on Cactus. There's one person remaining. And he actually jumps out of there like an absolute ninja. And he stops the bomb plant as well. Nicely done there by Nonolino. Playing the B site masterfully. 13-6. As Libya pick up their first round here with a fall bite. Good start here for the Libyans now. And great play by Nonolino, making the B site look very difficult for the Moroccans to take. The Moroccans were able to get a full buy, just a Desert Eagle on Cactus, however. Not all the utility that they can purchase, but more than enough. And the Libyans have to be careful of the fast pushes here. And they're not throwing the smokes perfectly. You can see the smokes can be improved from both sides. And this smoke can actually be taken advantage of. Ali Slack can use the smoke to get the entry. Bad Molotov there by Josh. And Ali Slack is there to take him out again. Small mistakes like this, not using your utility properly, can cost you rounds. Meredith with the flash. Flashing Frosty, who's trying to come into support. And there you have the truck smoke. But the terrorists are very slow. Very, very slow with their execute. Keeping the Libyans guessing. A nice drive by Cactus. Shooting through the squeaker that looked like it might have connected. And the Moroccans making sure that they're not going to get flanked or surprised by any CTs. Meredith giving away his position there with the shot. I think that was a mistake by Meredith. And the bomb will be moving towards the A site. And actually, Meredith in a great position with this flank. Slow A execute from the Moroccans. Libya, no idea what's going on. Entry, A site, easily taken. Masterful tactical play from the Moroccans. They're on the flashes and smokes, and you can see by the way the CTs responded that they thought it was a B execute. They just waited, then went for the A site, and it's completely worked out for them. Now the Libyans have to play for the retake. Meredith starts it off though, gets an entry on Cactus, but there's a return from Alice Leck. Crocodile coming in, takes down Razor over at the B site. Now it's a retake with Crocodile and Alina. They have to win these rounds. They can't give any more rounds away. And their economy will be absolutely crushed, however, so maybe it's a good point in time to go for the save those two M4s, because they won't have the loser bonus, and they won't have a lot of money either. So Morocco make it 14-6 here, with a very, very nice round there, and almost a double fake, if you want to call it that. There's a good call from the in-game leader of the Moroccans, or whoever actually made that call. And it's a good time to win a round as well, because Libyan's economy is in the gutter. That's what's worrying about over rotations and in the position they were in, they were one man down. They needed to do something. They needed to get a frag somewhere. Positions now by the CT is not very good, both at forklift. Smoke. Razor at B holes, putting in pressure, holding the flank as well, making sure that they don't get pushed by the Libyans, and also getting a lot of information for his side. Nelly Slack at mid. Default terrorist side here by the Moroccans. It's a good default as well. Raiders gets shot down by Ali Slack at mid. Entry for the terrorist once more. And usually when the Moroccans are able to get the entry, they do end up winning the round here. Flashes at mid as they take control of mid with Cactus. And the bomb's going to be picked up and moved towards the B site. Seems like it will be a B execute here from the Moroccans. Only one person in the site. It is Nonolino, though. Oh no, it's actually Crocodile this time around. Crocodile. He's holding the B site. CT smoke comes down. Nonolino smoke. Actually, it was a Molotov. Cactus gets the entry on Josh over on the A site. The one's moving towards the B site. It's all up to Crocodile and Nonolino here. Frosty's coming into support as well. Will Crocodile do much? Oh, he misses his shots. They know exactly where he is. Frosty. Far, far away, unable to support. Nonolino down, Crocodile down, and the Moroccans get an easy plant on the B site. Frosty on his own in a 1v3. He can pick up his teammates M4. He's still got his FAMAS, goes for the peak, sees Ali Slack. Ali Slack sees him, knows exactly where he is. You know he's coming in from CT spawn now. Actually, no. Ali Slack with a balcony nade. Oh, wow. Yoshi with that jump. Nice kill there by Yoshi. And that's for 15-6. Morocco have secured themselves the point. Libya now can't get those 3 points. and they have to win 9 rounds in a row if they want to get the draw. It's very difficult, so we're going to get a pause soon. They've been plagued with kind of internet problems with Crocodile, but it seems like the Moroccans just have that bit more, that little bit extra experience, and their aim is just a little bit better. Individually, the players have been having much better games. You know, Yoshi, Ali Slak, and Salah have had loads of individual rounds where they've picked up the rounds for their team. But Libya have been playing tactically sound CS. They've just not executed it properly. Pushing in towards the sites, they've not been checking the right angles. Some of their smokes are not landing properly. Some of their flashes are not landing properly. On the CT side, they're not holding their positions properly sometimes. And the rotations are coming in too fast, or they're getting faked basically by the Moroccans far too easily, so they're moved out of position. Either way, it's a good kind of learning curve here for the Libyans. They've played their game now, they've learned a lot from it, and now they've got something to play on going into their game against Egyptians. They've also warmed up as well, and you have to realize the Moroccans warmed up with their match against the Algerians, and that helps when you play a match or when you have a match before another match, or you have a practice match before an actual match. It always helps you, it always gets you into the game, gets you kind of warmed up pretty much and ready to play at your highest level. So that's also a good advantage for the Moroccans. And now the Libyans can take the experience that they've had in this game onto their next game against Egypt. Either way, though, Moroccans now well in their way to pick up 3 points. And they're just one round away. And with the bye that the CTs have at the moment, it seems likely that they're going to get it soon. Got a match paused here. Seems like one of the players disconnected. Meredith this time round. Just waiting for him to reconnect before we continue with this game, but how many people have you got on the stream at the moment? 11k, wow, fantastic. 11k watching CS, African CSGO. That is really, really nice to see. Warm welcome to all of you. Hope you've enjoyed the broadcast and enjoyed the match so far, and you've been enjoying the African CSGO. We've got African qualifiers every afternoon for the next 5 days, and we have the European qualifiers in the evening. Today we have two matches, one on EFRAG TV and the other on EFRAG TV 2, which will be cast by Joshua Newblood, whom you guys know from EFRAG TV as well. He's cast quite a lot of matches. But we've got another disconnect. I think, I'm really thinking that it's electricity. I really think it's electricity right now for Libya, because they've disconnected without like a timeout. And usually, and their Steam is probably still logged in. And usually that's what happens when your PC just suddenly turns off. So we'll get an update from the admins to see what's going on. Hopefully there's like everything's good, but we've got one reconnect, so I'm just waiting for Meredith right now. But do check out e-frag.net or twc.e-frag.net. the mods will throw it in the chat so you guys can see the links. TWC, you get all the information about the World Championships, all the stats, all the plays. Like, you'll get player stats and players information that you won't find on other websites, simply because they don't have them registered. So do check out, it's the best place for TWC coverage. There's loads of cool interviews with all the TWC players. We've got interview from an Egyptian player, Spanish player, Irish player, loads of interviews. So go check them out to see kind of the mentality of the players, and it'll help you, I guess, with your betting as well, to see how they think and how they feel, how confident they are and whatnot, and also to get information about them. So do check it out. We've got loads of people on the site at the moment, so let's have more people. And also e-frag.net for all CSGO coverage. We're getting a article by Lerpus that's going to be posted today. So freeze time's cancelled and Meredith logs in, but on the other hand we get a disconnect from Crocodile. Oh dear, internet problems, electricity problems. They're going to play the round anyway, and Crocodile's back, so everything's good. I don't know if he will be able to have time to buy something. Oh, he's just going to play the USB. And it's a force buy round here by the Libyans. Picks up his teammates 5-7, and Yoshi will get the entry there on Frosty. Just returns though, as the terrorists have full control of mid, moving towards the A site. There you have the deep Molotov over at quad, and the Moroccans will be able to get the bomb planted as well on the A site. CT's having to play for the retake. Just making sure if there was somebody over at Quad, goes for the fake plant, but nobody's there. Nice flash there by Salah. But Josh makes a frag on Razor, so this is a very good force buy here by the CTs. 4 versus 2. Salah, though. Takes down Merry Death. Oh, no, Nolinho. It's all up to Ali Slack now. In a 1 versus 3, gets the first frag and the second. Ali Slack, what an end. 3 frags for him. Morocco will take this 16-6. And again, a beautiful example of individual play from the Moroccans. And you have their first 3 points.